We know that the creation week culminates with the Sabbath. God works for 6 days, and then he comes to the end of the week, and he declares the entirety of his creation very good, and he rests, and he is delighted in his creation, and he's enthroned within his creation. So the week of work is moving toward this Sabbath. But there's another Sabbath pattern that's built into the creation account. It's not simply that God works full-time 24-6 for 6 days and then rests on the seventh day. There's a rest built into every day. There's a microcosm of the week that's in each day. God works during the daylight hours. He's doing something new each day. And then during the nighttime, in the dark, God rests from his work. What's interesting in the creation account is that you not only have that kind of Sabbath principle at work in a daily time frame as well as a weekly time frame, but the way that that pattern is described in Genesis 1 shows us that the rest time precedes the work time. Evening and morning are one day. The portion of the day that's not for work is designated as the first part of the day, and that gives us a clue to how we should think about Sabbath and rest within our own lives. We're not simply working toward rest. We don't work and work and work and so that we can take a rest. We're working out of a sense of rest and satisfaction and delight in God's goodness. And that keeps us from being frantic, keeps us from a kind of workaholism, because our work is done not scrambling so that we can get to the holiday, but our work is done out of a rest that's already achieved. And that pattern is also found in our daily work. And this becomes more and more difficult with contemporary technologies, where you can take your work home with you on the laptop. Your work is always with you. It's there in your pocket on your iPhone. You don't know when you're going to get a text or an email from your boss or from a customer. But the pattern that we find in the creation week and the pattern that God sets for us and calls us to is a pattern that renounces that kind of workaholism and has not only a time of weekly rest and weekly delight, but a time of daily delight. So put away the cell phone. Don't be a workaholic. Rest in God. Rest in his goodness. Delight in what he's enabled you to accomplish during the day. Rest in that evening. And then the next day, go into your work refreshed.